Let us now discuss the narrative method employed by Emily Bronte in her novel Wuthering Heights. The events narrated in Wuthering Heights cover a period of 30 years from the summer of 1771 to the autumn of 1802. In the novel, the histories of three generations of two families, the Earnshaws and the Lintons, are presented. Some parts of this history are presented in great detail. At times, several years are skimmed over in the space of a few pages. Two narrative methods were in vogue among Emily Bronte's contemporary novelists. The autobiographical method, in which the story is narrated in the first person by a character who was himself involved in the action, and third person narration, in which the story is presented by an omnipresent and omniscient spectator who is not personally involved in the action. So these were the two popular methods of narrating a story or writing a novel in those days. Emily Bronte chooses to employ neither of these. Instead of doing any of these two, she ignores chronological sequence. She uses two narrators, Mr. Lockwood, tenant at Thrushcross Grange, and the housekeeper, Nellie Dean. Lockwood arrives as a tenant at the Grange toward the end of November 1801. After paying a visit to his landlord, Mr. Heathcliff of Wuthering Heights, he is laid up with a cold for 2 months. He is an ordinary man and a curious one. He is puzzled by the relationships and strange behavior of the inhabitants of the Heights and questions his housekeeper, Nellie Dean. She, knowing all of the members of the two families in the story and having been personally involved in their histories, amuses him with her story during the period of his convalescence, that is, when he is getting well from his illness. By January 1802, Lockwood is sufficiently recovered to pay another visit to Heathcliff. He announces his intention to return to London for 6 months. He passes out of the book at this point, returning briefly in September 1802, when he visits Wuthering Heights and hears the conclusion of the tale from Mrs. Dean. After a visit to the graves of Edgar, Catherine and Heathcliff, he departs. In the novel, Lockwood presents the situation as he sees it. The reader is thus brought closer to the action, seeing it through the eyes of a narrator as normal as himself. His presence in the novel also permits the author to begin her story very near the end and work forward and backward in time. Nellie Dean is the second narrator in the novel. She has the advantage over Lockwood of having herself been involved in the action, since she was the confidant of a number of the major characters. Moreover, unless she had told the story to Lockwood, he could never have written it. Her qualifications as a storyteller are explained to Lockwood in these words: "I have undergone sharp discipline, which has taught me wisdom, and then I have read more than you fancy, Mr. Lockwood," unquote. It is she who pieces together the story from her own experience, from Heathcliff's story when a boy, from Isabella's letter, from Heathcliff's story, and from her conversation with Zillah. What Nellie is not expected to know is told by Lockwood or intimated through Catherine's diary. So the story of this novel has been narrated by these two narrators, Mr. Lockwood and Nellie Dean. Thank you.